Williams, Serena Bellissimo, Dean McGuinness and Jean Swallen. Good afternoon to you both. You're all very welcome. It's great to see you in the flesh, which is a fantastic thing. Also, we're joined by 20 remote testers. They've been sent, they all are there. They were sent a lovely Lidl hamper of goodies earlier on. And give us all a wave there. Go on, wave, all of you. Yes, they're waving. Now, we can't. We can only see them at the moment. We can't hear them because we can't understand their thick bogger accents. But now that I've insulted everybody who's taking part in the programme today, one person we can hear is our old friend Ivan Corliss, who's going to tell us about today's hashtag.
Hi, Sean. Festive greetings to one and all. Right, so from Tuesday's discussion about the controversy surrounding the lyrics of Fairytale of New York, right, today's very Christmassy hashtag is Christmas Tune Movies. That's C-H-O-O-N. So here's one to get the ball rolling. Silent Night, Mare on Elm Street. I'll see you all on Twitter. Cheers. Bye.
Right, that's it. Christmas Tune Movies is the hashtag today. And we might as well kick things off with an actual tune. Singing cod liver oil and orange juice. Here's the Merry Wallopers.
Ho, ho, ho! It's us, the Merry Wallopers, live again on News Talk. Here's cod liver oil and the orange juice. Woo! Yeah!
Out of the east, there came a hard man. Ho, ho, ho! All I ever break the night. Liver oil and the orange juice. He went into a pub and he came out paralytic. Oh ho ho, buckfast and cider. Ah, what a hell of a mixture. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Does this bus go to the Donathan Pally? Oh ho ho, looking for a lumber. Glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. They're in the dancing. He met Hairy Mary. Oh ho ho, the flower of the gorbals. Glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Oh, now, Mary, are you dancing? Oh, oh, no, it's just the way I'm standing. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Oh, now, Mary, you're one in a million. Oh, ho, ho, and so's your chances. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Oh, now, Mary, can I run you home? Oh, ho, ho, I've got a pair of sand shoes. Ah, 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 you're a hell of a funny. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. In through the back close and out through the dunny. Oh, ho, ho, it wasn't for the first time. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. The mother came out, she was going to the clergy. Oh, ho, ho, I buggered off sharpish. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Mary had a little baby. Oh ho ho, the father's in the army. Ah, glory, hallelujah. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Mary, Mary's looking for her hard man. Oh ho, he joined the foreign legion. Ah, Sahara under a camel. Cod liver oil and the orange juice. Cod liver oil and the orange juice.
you go. That's the Merry Wallopers there, the cod liver oil and the orange juice. Now, on the 23rd of December, the Merry Wallopers will be doing a live stream on YouTube, all for free, in their own pub. Well, it's actually their sitting room, which is made to look like a pub, though you can find out all about it on their Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. And Mairead's texting in to say that it's great to see us all back together. And she says she'd normally be at the outside broadcast. She's watching from her desk, but she says we're all looking shocking well. So congratulations, especially Leslie Williams, because we're all admiring his shoes. Where'd you get your shoes?
I got them in a TK Maxx.
You got, no, I'm totally down with that. I love the TK Maxx. That's
They Goodyear welted, which means they're
Goodyear welted.
Yeah, it's a complicated process where it means you can replace the soles and heels forever.
Right.
It means they're expensive. But normally they'd be like 200-300. Okay. These were like 60, 70.
TK Maxx was the only place where a man came on to me once. I think he was coming on to me. Maybe Serena and Jean, you can tell me. But I was trying on a pair of shoes and he just unbidden walked up to me and says, yeah, they look good.
So moving on.
Yeah. Does that happen a lot?
It hasn't happened to me, sadly.
Well, you should not go back in again, Leslie. It's only a matter of time. Kieran says, I need a good wine that will get me through the mother-in-law's rotten food. Like I may get food poisoning. Prayers and thoughts are welcome, says Kieran. Is there any wine that will actually murder the taste of food?
Oh, something with lots of alcohol. Yeah. That'll just get you through the mother-in-law. That's, you know, full stop. So, you know, something from the New World that's got absolutely tons of alcohol, you know, at the 14.8%, just nudging over to the 15%, you know, something, where would you go?
Amarone is 16%.
Oh, yeah, Amarone. Yeah. Italy. Yeah. And it's so cool. Everybody loves Amarone. Yeah. Maybe an Amarone from Italy.
No, but a big rich Malbec, like you were saying, would work out.
Yeah.
And you could also conjure up enough hypocrisy to say that was delicious.
Yeah, you see, so you'll have so much like the flavour from the wine, you just won't taste the food.
That's a good tip. What style of beer would Dean recommend to go with my Christmas dinner? I'm thinking stout must be the way to go, but I'm not sure. I'm not as much of a beer drinker as my brother who's coming over and it's in him who'll be drinking it.
Okay, well, I do an entire day of Christmas dinner, so I start out with a champagne beer in the morning, sometimes with orange juice, depending on who's drinking it. That's about 11 in the morning. With Christmas dinner, barley wine is superb. But what we'll be having this year is Rodenbach Alexander. And what that is, it's a cherry-flavoured sour Flanders red.
Crikey.
And it has a substitute for the cranberry sauce to go with the turkey.
Gotcha.
And it works really, really well.
Pour it over the turkey or just, no, do you drink just, it? Just,
yeah,
okay.
Yeah. It's a 750ml bottle. Right.
Neither will do, presumably. Aoife says, as much as I like drinking the, I like watching the exact same Christmas movies every year, have there been any good Christmas movies in the last 5 years? It's not a difficult question to answer, I would have thought.
There's a new one that I absolutely love on Netflix called Jingle Jangle.
Right.
And it's just gorgeous. It stars Felicia Rashad from Creed. She plays the mother to Creed. It also has Ricky Martin as this gorgeous little cartoon-like character. It's about a little girl whose granddad owns a magical toy shop. And when her mum was little, everything was going well until one of the workers came and stole his idea. The idea that could have made them multimillionaires.
Oh.
And so then he loses touch with the family and the daughter comes back and there's just Forest Whitaker stars in it and there's just gorgeous Christmas music and it's something different that you haven't seen. I watched it with the kids, gosh, maybe a couple of months ago now I previewed it and we all loved it. There's something for everyone. It's a gorgeous musical.
Okay, that sounds lovely.
And Home Alone turns 30, so you have to throw in Home Alone.
Have you seen the Netflix Lesbians at Christmas one?
What's that one?
Oh, I forget her name that's in it. You know the pasty face one that had the affair with the director and then everybody hates her, who was in that film where
Twilight.
She was,
those details Twilight. Are amazing.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. The woman Twilight. From Twilight, yeah.
Kristen.
Yeah. Yeah. And she's in a relationship with another one whose name I can't remember, but she was in a Terminator film. She's very tall.
I haven't, no, I must get onto that. Actually, the kids...
Well, it's terrible, don't bother.
Oh, okay.
That's my general, that's my review. Kev wants to know, can you ask any of your wonderful, all-knowing wine and booze gurus if this bottle of wine is worth drinking or... Well, they can't see it. Surely you're going to have to bring it in. The 14.8%, she'd only end up fighting the mother-in-law with that stuff, says another text, which is probably a fair point. Let's have our first wine, Jean. A Chenin Blanc.
A Chenin Blanc from South Africa. Now, all the wines are exclusive, obviously, to Lidl. And this is, they have two Chenin Blanc. They have the Fair Trade one, which is, it's not that. It's the actual Chenin Blanc from Paarl. And you'll see P-A-A-R-L on the label. That means pearl. It's actually a wine region in South Africa. In Afrikaans, it translates from pearl. That's what it actually means. This one is $7.99. Now, I love Chenin Blanc. It's a grape variety that originated in the Loire Valley. And it's probably the very first grape that was actually planted in South Africa back in 1655, when Jan van Riebeck, who was a Dutch doctor, set up a trading post. Well, it wasn't really a trading post. A lot of it was to do with the fact that the ships going from India to back to Europe bringing very expensive commodities such as spices and tea. The sailors never made it back to the whole voyage because they used to get scurvy and a lot of them got very sick. So they discovered vitamin C was the solution. So they sent Jan van Riebeck down to set up a kind of a halfway point in what is now Cape Town. And he brought some French grapes from the Loire, and it's believed it was Chenin Blanc. And in fact, one of the most widely planted grape varieties in South Africa, even today, it's about 18% of the total plantings is Chenin Blanc. And it's actually one of their best white grape varieties. And there's an awful lot of old vine Chenin Blanc as well, which, you know, some of the vines are 40, 50 years old and even more. And that means you get this lovely concentrated flavor from the vines. But Paarl is it's next door to Stellenbosch. And it's one of the very good quality regions within South Africa. And that's where this particular wine comes from. Now, the thing about Chenin Blanc is it's one of the acidic grapes. So like, say, Sauvignon Blanc or Albarino, it's actually got lots and lots of acidity. But unlike Sauvignon, it's got more of a honeyed character on it. And if you stick your nose in there, you'll certainly get a little bit of honey coming through. The fruit profile is more citrus, but there is that slight tinge of honey. It's not like a Sauvignon, which is all grassy and, you know, tomato leaf. This is it's a much more restrained nose. And then when you try it, you've got that acidity, but it's not like puckering stuff. It's not sort of making you salivate enormously. It's just kind of gentle and easy acidity coming through. And that honeyed flavour is coming through onto the palate. Lovely wine. At $7.99, that's great value. That punches way above its weight. Now, what'll I go with? Well, if you like smoked salmon, and everybody, let's face it, loves a bit of smoked salmon at Christmas time. It's something we all put in our supermarket trolleys and it's always in the shelf, you know. Oh, somebody's arrived. Not that anybody would be arriving unexpectedly this Christmas, but you know, let's just imagine somebody arrives unexpectedly and you say, oh, I've got some lovely smoked salmon in the fridge. Well, pull out a bit of brown bread. You don't need a wedge of lemon on your smoked salmon if you've got a lovely acidic wine like that. And enjoy.
Okay, fantastic. Or you can give it to them in the front garden with a plate of smoked salmon.
Yeah, you can do that. Yeah, you can do that.
A few people are texting as well. You can watch this if you want to watch the live stream. We're on News Talk Facebook and News Talk's Twitter account. That will all have this as it's happening. The movie I was thinking of is called Happiest Season. And it's got Kristen Stewart and Dan Levy from Schitt's Creek is in it.
Oh,
it does have a great cast, it must be said.
Is that on Netflix?
It's on Netflix, yeah. Now, this person said they thought it was great, but I thought it was... Eh.
What about Dan Levy? Because everyone's talking about Dan Levy being great in it. I was going to watch it for him.
Yeah, but he's the same character as Schitt's Creek, really, which is fine.
Perfect.
Yeah, it's just it nearly got there, but then I thought, I don't get it. This woman doesn't come out to her family, even though they seem a completely liberal family.
Okay.
And you don't know why she didn't do it in the first place.
So maybe just watch Schitt's Creek.
Yeah. I know a gentleman who met his husband in TK Maxx. So now, Leslie, there's still hope. Agar says, absolutely love. He's straight, by the way. Dan Levy is great, but a one-note actor. But he's so enjoyable, I'm okay with that, says another texter.
I won't have a bad thing said about Dan Levy.
Oh, no. He is. He's fantastic.
Yeah, he is. Yeah. Thanks.
But you couldn't see him doing an action movie. Unless he was the comic relief.
Maybe he could write himself a character that would work for us.
Well, kind of a superhero who uses sarcasm. out rather than
and
his
really
muscles.
Well dressed.
Yeah, that would be great. Absolutely love Jingle Jangle. Can't think of a bad film with Forrest Whitaker in it. Says Gar. Another texter wants to know: has Serena seen Hillbilly Elegy yet? I'm thinking of watching it tonight as I love Amy Adams, but read a bad review earlier. What does she think?
So it got slammed.
It did
by critics. I don't understand why it got slammed. I think it's a really tough watch. It's about a family who. The effects that someone who is taking drugs has on their life. So, you know, you're used to seeing stories where it's from the person who's addicted. Now this is what addiction does to someone else's family. And I don't know, I found it a tough watch. So yeah. I don't know if I'd watch it on a Friday night for pure escapism. But if you're looking for something that might make you think, that might be worth watching. I love everything Ron Howard does.
Right, but did you think it was true? There seemed to be...
There's a lot of
criticism. But it wasn't a real, it was kind of patronizing. It wasn't a true depiction of.
A lot of people took offense at the way the hillbilly culture was depicted, but yeah. I didn't think it was that. I took it more as this is one family. This isn't saying what the culture is like. This is what one family experienced. And I think for me, it was interesting to see a depiction of what addiction does to somebody else, not the person going through it. So,
is it okay to call them hillbillies? That might be kind of insulting.
I don't know. It's called
to hillbillies.
It's called hillbilly allergy.
Yeah. That's true. Good point. Wine with smoked salmon. Wow. I would have assumed that both flavors would overpower each other and just make for an unfortunate experience. I don't know if they mean diarrhea.
Smoked salmon is a flabby fish, right? It's an oily fish. So what you need is a wine with a bit of acidity to give it a bit of a lift. So you put an acidic wine with any sort of oily fish, be it mackerel, smoked mackerel or trout or anything that's got, anything that's weighty or oily, it'll work really. Try it.
Okay.
Really,
all right. Well, actually, let's
champagne.
Go to our Zoom.
Champagne as well. Yes.
Let's go to our Zoom panel. See what their stuff with smoked salmon as well. What did you think of it? I don't know if they're listening to me, to be honest. I think they've got bored and drifted off. But anyway, well done. Thanks for that review. Right. Okay. We might as well take a commercial break. We'll talk about our first movie after this.
Moncrieff on News Talk. Santa will visit over 2,500 children in emergency accommodation this Christmas. That's why this weekend at News Talk, we've joined with Focus Ireland to ask you to give the greatest gift you can give a child this Christmas, a home. We're asking you to please support Focus Ireland this Christmas and help to raise €1.2 million to help get families across Ireland back into the safety and security of their own home. Find out how to donate now at focusireland.ie/donate. Supported by News Talk.
Citizensinformation.ie has been viewed over 38 million times during the pandemic as a trusted source of free advice and information on everything from tenants' rights to pandemic payments and getting back to work. Our information officers are ready to help you navigate the changes in your life on 0761 074 000 or visit citizensinformation.ie to book a callback. Citizens Information, a source you can trust. Funded and supported by the Citizens Information Board. Call costs depend on operator bundles.
Get Christmas wrapped up with Harvey Norman, with gifts they'll really love. Get the slim and portable Samsung Galaxy Tab A7 10.4-inch tablet for only €199, save €50. Or get them the Samsung Galaxy A51 SIM-free smartphone for only €324 after cashback. And we won't be beaten on price with our best price guarantee. For more, see harveynorman.ie or shop safely in our spacious stores. Christmas wrapped up with Harvey Norman.
Searching for car insurance? Call Sheridan Insurances. We can save you up to 25% on your car insurance and we offer easy payment plans. Call the team of experts at Sheridan Insurances today. Sheridan Insurances Limited, trading as Sheridan Insurances, is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland. Terms and conditions apply. Minimum premium of €290. Acceptance criteria, terms and conditions apply.
Certainty. With Volkswagen commercial vehicles, it's included as standard. The Crafter, Transporter and the all-new 5th generation Caddy are more innovative, dynamic and efficient than ever before. Now with HP finance from 0%, purchase contributions of up to €3,500 and service plans from €9.99, they're the smart next step for your business. For vans and offers you can rely on always. Contact your local Volkswagen commercial vehicles dealer or visit volkswagenvans.ie and leave the rest to us. Finance provided by way of hire purchase agreement from Volkswagen Financial Services Ireland and subject to lending criteria. Terms and conditions apply.
This Christmas is all about staying safe. And the perfect gift is a voucher for somewhere you know that has been caring for its guests for over 20 years. Somewhere you know that's an oasis of calm and relaxation. Somewhere you know that has the finest wild and organic foods and just a short journey from Dublin. The Brook Lodge at McCredden Village, County Wicklow. Call 0402 36444 or buy online at brooklodge.com.
Christmas compromises are unavoidable, like wrapping your gifts in newspaper because you ran out. Don't compromise this Christmas with OnPost Mobile. Get unlimited 4G data, calls and texts, plus 99% 4G population coverage. All for just €15 a month and your first month free when you switch. Pay as you go, no contract or bills. We're open for business as usual and close to home. So pop into your local post office or visit onpost.com/mobile today to shop our full range, including the Samsung Galaxy A21s from just $129.95. OnPost Mobile. Offer available for new customers. Fair usage policy applies. For T's and C's, see onpost.com/mobile.
Time to whet those appetites with Aldi's delicious nibbles and bites. At only $2.49, there's chicken bites and chicken Kiev bites. Totally tempting tempura prawns, just $2.99. 10 delicious, specially selected vegan roses, $3.49. And Costolore Prosecco Frizzante DOC, $7.86. Perfect time to raise a toast to the day of the year we all love the most. Enjoy an amazing Aldi Christmas. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
Moncrief's Fact of the Day. This is so good, you'll need to sit down.
When you blush, the lining of your stomach turns red too.
Moncrief's Fact of the Day.
Bet you didn't know that now, did you?
53106 is our text number. That will cost you 30 cents. You are listening and indeed possibly watching the Moncrief Show on News Talk. This is part of our special Christmas movies and booze with thanks to our friends at Lidl. We have a host of our regulars here. Jean was just telling us about a Shannon Blanc there. People want you to repeat the name of the Shannon Blanc, Jean.
It's literally called the Lidl Shannon Blanc. The vintage is 2019. And the specific one that I'm reviewing now has Parl, P-A-A-R-L, which means it's the name of the region it's from on the label. And it's also got some kind of an animal, but I can't remember what. But you'll know, it's actually part of their core range. So it's there all the time.
Yeah.
So it's one of their regular wines. And it's a lovely wine. It's one I like, actually.
And of course, we will be putting the names of all these wines up on our website anyway, in the not too distant future. Did Jean just say a flabby fish? Nothing sounds more disgusting than a flabby fish. Turns me right off. Well, you don't have to date it. You're just trying to eat it. That's the point. In Hillbilly Elegy, Adele says, Amy Adams, Glenn Close, The Sun. It was the best film of 2020. The women were so strong and broken and tough and loving. The way they looked after each other and respected the dead, I thought there was a lot of positives in it, says Adele. I think it's just kind of split people.
It really has. Yeah. They'll all be up for Oscars, especially Glenn Close.
Yeah.
That's her Oscar movie.
Klaus on Netflix it's spelled K-L-A-U-S, but is
Klaus.
That Klaus? Yeah, Klaus as in Santa Claus.
It's really good.
Right, okay. And Sharky from Dundalk says, I met you in the checkout queue in TK Maxx about 5 years ago. I complimented you on the quirky nature of the stories in your show. You said it was all down to the researchers, to which I replied, great. Then the conversation stopped. There was an awkward silence and the queue seemed to last for hours. It was all very uncomfortable. Just to be clear, I wasn't coming on to you, says Sharky from Dundalk. Yeah, see, I wasn't sure. That was the thing. Do you and you have... that was a kind of an awkward one. Do any of your panel have a strange Christmas movie tradition? Me and the family always sit down to watch John Carpenter's The Thing. Once a year, every year. Nothing says Christmas like murderous aliens running around Antarctica. Says Porik. No, none of us do. It's just you, Porik. Lads, I feel like I'm missing out. I'm craving smoked salmon and wine. What are you doing to me here? We're just showing you an alternative form of life. And Dermot says, my brother only serves beer for Christmas dinner. I get awfully gassy and burp my way through. Any beer I can ask him to stock that might be less gassy, says Dermot.
That's gassy. Now, if it's a bottle-conditioned beer, what will happen is the carbonation in the beer will develop in the bottle. Sometimes it can be quite high, but it's an awful lot smoother. So you tend not to feel like you're taking huge, big bubbles of gas into yourself. As a general rule, the best trick for less gassy beers is either a vintage beer where it'll lose a certain amount of carbonation over time, so a beer that's 5-10 years old, or if you were in a pub, which unfortunately isn't happening much these days, would be a cask conditioned beer because the carbonation is particularly low. If you're looking for lower carbonation, stay away from German wheat ales, and sometimes Belgian ales as well can have quite high carbonation. So.
Or could we just derm it?
Does Dean have, this would be a good thing, does Dean have a beer advent calendar? I got a wine one, but I would love to have a beer one. Is there such a thing?
There are people doing beer advent calendars. Sometimes they'll do it with 12 beers as opposed to 24 beers, just kind of giving you a bit of a thing. But yeah, there are gift packs that are being done by a few of the online stores, and they do it each year and put together a selection of different beers, just kind of variety of different things to have over the
Okay, that sounds fun. Yeah. We're going to move on to our first film of the day. And because we're live streaming this, you'll be able to see the clip for a change. So it's called The Prom. Here's the clip.
Hello, interweb. My name is Emma Nolan, and I'm 17. You might have heard about the prom in Indiana.
I just want to go to prom like any other kid.
All opposed.
I know we all have stories to tell, and here's mine.
Oh my gosh, check this out.
It's all over Twitter.
She wanted to take her girlfriend to the high school prom. And the PTA went apeshit and they canceled it.
We have got to go down there.
Yes.
And raise holy hell.
Yes, we will be the biggest thing to happen in Indiana since whatever's happened in Indiana.
Right, more lesbians at Christmas. What's the deal with that?
I love this movie. Like, this is the movie that we all need to see in 2020. I have to say, I think... It's funny, I want to watch back all the films I've watched this year, maybe in 5 years' time, and see if I still react to them the way I've reacted to them this year. Because I think we're all hyper-emotional and hypersensitive at the moment with everything that's going on. So with this, I just cried, I laughed, I was filled with such hope. It is based on a Broadway play, which was in turn based on a true story. Back in, I hope I get this right, Itawamba Agricultural High School in Mississippi. There was a girl called Constance Mullen in 2010, and she wanted to bring her girlfriend to the prom. And the PTA, the Parents and Teachers Association, said no and cancelled the prom. So it was based on that. Here's a bit of a side note. She went on to be awarded $35,000 and damages from court.
Sweet.
Yeah, but this was then a Broadway play. And I love what they've done with the movie. When you see the cast, and you see Ryan Murphy, if his name's attached to anything, you know it's going to be fabulous. Even if you don't enjoy his movies, visually, his movies are stunning. And then he goes and he assembles a cast like Nicole Kidman.
James Corden.
Meryl Streep was the name that I couldn't remember.
Ah, right, yes. Yeah.
Meryl Streep and Kerry Washington. And they are fabulous. The first three are actually playing narcissistic stage stars who have lost favor with the community and their fans. So they think, what can we do? Well, celebrities are really important. And when they take on a cause, people seem to love celebrities. So they like, it takes a little jab at celebrity, and they basically decide, they see this case and they go, we're going to go and take her to prom. But when they turn up, they stuff everything up. And then it's, can she eventually have her prom or not? And it's just, it's such a gorgeous, gorgeous film. There's, if you love musicals, there's gorgeous song and dance numbers. It's so over the top, so fabulous. I can't rave about it anymore.
Yeah, it's Ryan Murphy. But what you told us right at the start there, was that a spoiler for the film?
No.
That they called off the prom?
No, because I'm allowed to say that.
Okay, all right.
Yeah.
You are allowed to say
so
that.
So basically they have, and that's why the stars turn up, because they want the prom back on.
People would have noticed there that James Corden was doing an American accent. How convincing was it?
He was really good. I think because of the type of character he's playing in this. Thank goodness this year he went with this, because he had to make up for Cats last year. Cats was absolutely terrible. And you know, when there's a film that's so bad it's good, we can't even say that about Cats. So if this year you're going, do you know what, I might give Cats a watch, just don't. Watch The Prom instead. It's so good. Ryan Murphy has actually said that he made this movie because this is something that's so passionate to him. When he was growing up, he went to prom but always went with his coolest girlfriends because he couldn't bring his own dates. And he longed to see a film like this. And he says, my greatest Christmas wish is that this movie brings a sense of hope and community to anyone who needs it in these troubling times. And I think we all need to see that. We all need a bit of joy. And that's what you're getting from The Prom. It's so joyous.
Okay, fair enough. Now, at the same time, you will be aware there's a lot of people who hate James Corden. I don't want to keep banging on about this, but that might be a turnoff for some people.
And it could be. And do you know what? I have a bit of a love-hate relationship when it comes to James Corden. But in this, like, if you're watching, if you're not into musicals, don't go anywhere near this film, right? But if you're into musicals, he suits his character. Like, he's been cast perfectly. Yeah. And then him with Meryl Streep and him with Nicole Kidman. And then the two newcomers as well, Joellen Pallman and Ariana DeBose, who was in Hamilton, and she's also going to be in Steven Spielberg's West Side Story. Cannot wait to see that. They are fabulous as the leads. And then Kerry Washington plays the mum of one of the girls that she doesn't know her daughter is gay.
Right. Okay.
So it's a beautiful movie.
Has Ryan Murphy made many movies? I thought it was mostly huge deals for Netflix he had.
Massive deals for Netflix. So he did, most of the things he has done, I've been thinking about the series he's doing. So stuff like Hollywood and Ratched. It's a lot of series. I don't know if this, I wouldn't say it's his first, but it'd be one of his first maybe.
Yeah, I don't know.
It's really good.
I suppose there was a kind of, you're always like, you don't even need to see the opening titles. You watch 5 minutes of it, you know it's a Ryan Murphy.
You do.
And that's going to turn you off or not.
Exactly. But do you know what? Even if you're not into Ryan Murphy's world, I don't think anyone depicts the world like Ryan Murphy does. It's just so beautiful. It's all, and like, this is set in the current day, but it's so old school as well. And just the colours that we're craving. I just think at the moment we're all craving something that is bright and joyous and gives us hope. And with this film, you're going to get all of that.
Mm. People wouldn't normally associate Alabama with bright and joyous.
No, do
they address race at all in this?
No, it's Indiana.
Well, it's Indiana. Sorry, yeah. I thought it was Alabama. Right,
but even,
okay. Maybe
but do you know what? Yeah. Even there. So race, this is all about the LGBTQ+ community.
Yeah. Did Serena say this is a musical? I never understood why Hollywood producers do musical versions of real life stories, especially when there's a serious story. It just sucks all the meaning and the humanity out of it.
Not at all. Oh my God, the musical pieces. You'll find yourself crying because I think sometimes music you can connect with even more so. I just think those moments, those dance pieces and stuff, it's all. And with, I keep banging on about Ryan Murphy, but with him at the helm, he's intertwined everything so beautifully. Now, I'm a massive, obviously, Ryan Murphy fan. I have a few friends who aren't, and they watched it and went, because I always complain when things go for 2 hours or longer.
Yeah.
I did not feel the 2 hours. But again, it's also, I think, as I said at the beginning, I think the films that you're watching this year and the TV shows you're watching this year are probably very different to what you did last year.
Because, yeah, you're basically running out of stuff to watch.
And,
so you watch anything.
That too.
Yeah.
That too. Because there have been stuff going, I've gone, really? Why did I just sit through that? But I also think that we're looking for joy. And if you're looking for some joy and some fun and some hope and some brightness, this is the film for you.
He did The Boys in the Band for Netflix as well.
He did, actually.
Which was also a play, I think.
It was. And that is, again, that was a really hard watch. But wow, such an amazing film.
James Corden is like the bad smell that won't go away. He's on every show, every movie, every advert. Why? Who likes him enough that they put him in everything, says Limo. But they like him in America,
The Americans love him because for this part, I actually spoke to James Corden about, name drop. I spoke to him for this film and he was saying that he didn't audition. He was tapped on the shoulder by by Ryan Murphy.
Mm.
So the Americans really, really love him. And once you're in Ryan Murphy's world, he is set for life because he tends to use the same actors over and over. And he also gives actors their big breaks too.
I don't think James Corden needs the money though.
Probably somehow. Not.
Yeah. BrewDog do a beer advent calendar.
Okay.
Apparently so.
Yeah.
All the, this texter says, let's just scroll it down there. No, I've missed it. Right. Okay. We might as well take a commercial break. We've more music and we've an India Pale Ale to come up after this.
Moncrief on News Talk.
InsureMyCars.ie.
Make it a really good afternoon and check out the great car insurance discounts at InsureMyCars.ie. Ireland's trusted car insurance specialists. For super family savings, check out
InsureMyCars.ie.
City Financial Marketing Group Limited, trading as InsureMyCars.ie, is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland.
At Audi, we know some drivers go to extremes to show they love their car. While now there's an easier way. Introducing the all-new Audi service subscription.
Enjoy two Audi services plus a full vehicle health check, 12 months roadside assistance, wiper blade replacement, and much more. Show your Audi some love from just $13.99 per month over 24 months. Book your Audi service subscription now at audiservice.ie. Terms and conditions apply. Audi. Vorsprung durch Technik.
One thing is certain. We all need something to look forward to. So why not give your loved ones the gift of a night away with a gift voucher for one of Ireland's amazing accommodation options. Choose from a romantic night, a relaxing night, or even a family night. This Christmas, give them an Irish accommodation gift voucher because we could all do with looking forward to a break in 2021. Search online for great voucher options. Brought to you by Fáilte Ireland.
Let your Christmas story begin in a place not far away, where every Sunday Santa Claus will read magical tales for all the family to enjoy, where all your favorite stores and all your Christmas shopping await, and where you and your little ones can video chat with Santa Claus himself from the comfort of your own home. Let your Christmas story begin at liffeyvalley.ie.
We all want to stay cozy and save on home energy. You can do both at boardgoshenergy.ie, where you can get our best ever dual fuel home energy offer. Save and switch today, exclusively at boardgoshenergy.ie. EAB of €1,397. 29% electricity discount and 38% gas discount with 12-month contract on standard unit rates with direct debit and paperless billing. Early exit fee €50, unit rate and standing charge apply. Prices valid today and may vary. See boardgoshenergy.ie for EAB and full T's and C's.
Malloy's, Dublin's oldest off-license, now delivering all your corporate gifts and wines nationwide. Shop in-store or online at malloys.ie. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
There's something about Christmas. There's something about it that creeps inside and finds the child in you. I was having a look around the shops to see what Santa might be bringing the boys, and there was this train set. Old style, black engine with maroon stripe, green and black carriages, all set up like. And the sound it made. Soft. Yet it cut right through all the space-agey screeches in the place. And I remembered another Christmas morning. Waking up, the windows frosted over with cold. You could see your breath. And the thing that woke me was that sound. And I didn't dare hope. Sliding out of bed, cold at the floor. And there it was, going round and round on the bedroom rug. I ran down, could barely speak. Mum and Dad were sitting there.
What is
the teapot covered in that knitted cosy and the smell of hot Dad, milky tea and rushers.
You'll never guess what Santa brought.
You'll never guess what Santa brought, I said.
Well, doesn't that beat Banner,
said my mother. A train set, no less. Isn't Santa the smart fella?
Turn the moment gold with Barry's Cold Blend Tea.
So last night, when I came home with the train set, Mary couldn't believe it.
That's not what they wanted at all,
she said. Santa'll bring them what they want, I said. This is from me. Put the kettle on, we'll have a cup of tea.
Moncrief. This is News Talk.
Walking through the city was as lonely as could be. I wandered in the nighttime out in search of company. Feel real isolation when all around me life familiar but unfriendly, unfriendly with no choice. I can see the evil, but I can feel the good shining out to greet me from within bone and blood. Throwing off this loneliness, I can't stick it anymore. Only need myself tonight to open up that door. And I know that sometimes it gets so bad. But you're not on your own, so don't be sad. Cause if you feel revived, you're not on your own night. Please don't be sad. so sad, 'cause you're not on your own tonight. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. The sea ain't only feeling. Don't have to tell me nothing, 'cause you know I know the feeling. Everybody seems to think it's they who bear the pain, they who bear the biggest cross, the loneliness and the shame. Day to day you suffer when you're living in your past. If you started living for the now, you can free yourself at last. If you started living for the now, for yourself and those around, experience and celebrate the freedom that you found. You could free yourself forever and live life as you should. The choice is yours to take now, and set all that accord. But I know that sometimes it gets so bad, but you're not on your own, so don't be sad. 'Cause if you feel it bad, you're not on your own tonight. Please don't. Tonight. Please don't be so sad, 'cause I'm not on your own tonight. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. You see, I know the feeling. Don't have to tell me nothing, 'cause you know I know the feeling. You're not on your own tonight. You say you're not on your own tonight. You're not on your own tonight.
The unmistakable Damien Dempsey there, You're Not On Your Own Tonight. And Damien and his band are going to be performing just exclusively. It's a Christmas live online concert at Stabal. For more information on how to get tickets, you can go into stabal.com. Serena was telling us about The Prom. It is on Netflix.
It's on Netflix,
yeah. James Corden is popular, says Tom, because he is the kitsch, fat everyman, nothing to do with talent. Somebody else wants to know, what wine do I need to drink to forget I'm watching James Corden in this movie? So, not a lot of positivity there. Also, this seems to be a theme. Amanda says, all the food on Christmas Day tends to give me a tender enough tummy. Is there a more gentle wine I could be drinking?
Gentle wine.
Basically, there seems to be a lot of fart around Christmas time.
Something with lower acidity.
Something maybe Chardonnay.
Yeah.
Once you say the C word, everybody hates Chardonnay, but which is so unfair. But yeah.
What would I think?
Yeah. Jude says Lidl are doing a big beer selection box. Got it the other day. Fabulous gift idea. Paul wants to know, would you please ask the wine expert about a recommendation for a full-bodied red wine for 50 euro plus? It's for my 50th birthday. So the sad, what we can infer from that is
birthday.
Paul has to buy himself a present for his 50th birthday. That's so sad.
1970
Paul.
Was a decent year for port. He should try and buy himself some 1970 vintage port. We're not going to find it, of course. It's impossible to find. But go for something. Go for something. But
don't bother, Paul. Just give up.
Now, here's the thing, right? So you can't get anything from 50 years ago, but 2010 was an amazing vintage in Bordeaux and in much of Europe. So if you should be able to find 2010 Bordeaux's around in, say, the likes of, say, Mitchell's or some of the better wine shops. Just to find in Port Marnock, they might have something. Now, during the COVID stuff, all the good wine got sold out. People were drinking way above what the price they would normally do. Bordeaux lasts, as does as does Ryaka. He needs something that has a bit of age in it, I think, because he's aged himself now. He needs something to be able to help him think about what he was doing on his 40th birthday. So I think he should get something from 2010.
Yeah, and he's obviously alone.
Yes, so, clearly.
Brian says, can Nicole Kidman sing? I mean, she can barely act these days with whatever she's done to her face, which isn't fair. And she can sing. She sings the opening song of The Undoing, doesn't she?
And she sang in Moulin Rouge. Like, that's when we all discovered that she could sing. One thing I must say, a massive Nicole Kidman fan for obvious reasons, but her face not moving.
What are the obvious reasons?
Australian.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Right. Yeah.
And she's a redhead.
Like, I just wish she'd allegedly ease up on her face, because it's just not moving. Like, I watched The Undoing and it just, there were emotions she couldn't give us, and she is a really good actress.
I know. Yeah. And like, your husband is a psychopathic murderer and no reaction whatsoever.
Because she can't.
Less than believable. Oh, sorry, spoiler alert, but it was crap anyway. Right, Dean, let's move on to our second, this is our first beer of the day. This is an India Pale Ale.
Yep. So this is the Crafty Brewing Company IPA. So Crafty Brewing Company is the own label brand by Lidl, and they have a range of different beers. They have an American brown ale, they have a saison. It's quite nice because a lot of the time with own label beers, they can focus on the key styles that work very well. So they do have a pale ale, they do have a lager. Obviously an IPA is the most popular style of beer in terms of craft beer. But they have an American brown ale, which would be more of a niche style, and also a saison, which is definitely more of a niche style. This is it's an interesting one to categorize. They describe it as a noble and fruity pale ale. Normally, when they're describing the type of IPA it is, they'll give clues as to the type of hops that are in it. And noble hops are a specific type of hops that aren't in this. So just in case somebody sees the noble and thinks that that's a reference to Spalter Tettnanger or Hallertauer or Sats, not the hops that are in this. What you've got is American hops giving really good fruit flavour. So apricot, grapefruit, not so much pine. With West Coast IPA, often you get a citrus pine type balance, but on this it's much more on the fruit side. It's a classic IPA. One of the things, sometimes when I'm chatting to people about craft beer, I'll say to them, oh, do you like craft beer? And they go, craft beer, IPA. Yeah, of course, yeah, I like IPA. And as if IPA is all craft beer, and that would be the equivalent of saying Chardonnay is all wine, thing. It is most definitely the most popular style of craft beer, but there are lots of different styles around it. And because IPA is the most popular style, it has subdivided into a whole range of different styles. So you've got black IPA, white IPA, red IPA, brown IPA, rye IPA, session IPA, double IPA, which is stronger IPA, imperial IPA. You have now sour IPA, which
there's
is
a sentence you can only say while sober, really.
Yeah. And with this, this is kind of heading towards the kind of classic American IPA. So it has the American hop character, apricot, grapefruit. Bitterness is around 50, 55 would be my best guess. On the label, they're a little bit less detailed. They do specify it as having very high bitterness. So they have a scale on the label of 1 to 5. They put it at 5, but it's a well-balanced beer. So it's not a beer where the bitterness is coming through. Bitterness is the flavor you get at the back of your tongue, and it's similar to what you'll get from quinine tonic, that type of flavor. It has enough bitterness to balance, but not an excessively bitter IPA. Sometimes you'll get IPAs with bitterness of anything up to 100% higher than this. So it's well balanced. So when you see it on the scale at 5, it's not necessarily something that if you find bitterness challenging, that you'll find a huge perceptual bitterness in it.
Yeah, and this is like, it doesn't feel like 6%.
It's 6%. The range for a classic IPA is 5.5 to 7.5%. And what you often find with the Irish IPAs, there's another thing as well. Sometimes you'll see Irish Pale Ale abbreviated to IPA, and usually that's a pale ale, which would be the step below, usually around the 4 to 5% mark. This is an Irish IPA. But they do specify it as an India Pale Ale, which is the style. But yeah, sometimes because, as a general rule of thumb, well, first of all, our pint is 20% larger than America. So in Ireland, we have a, what the Americans would describe as a 20 fluid ounce pint, where they have a 16 fluid ounce pint. So we've got a kind of a notable difference in the size of the pint. But in general, the alcohol strength of the mainstream beers are brought down by a similar amount.
Yeah.
So where a beer would be 5% in other countries, typically it's 4.3%. What can happen then is some of the Irish breweries bring their ABV down a touch, just because people are expecting a little bit less ABV in Ireland. So this is at 6%. It's respectably within the IPA range. Sometimes you'll see them at 6.5%, 7.5%.
Yeah, I'm glad we're recording the pictures of this today, because we can turn that IPA sentence into a meme later on. Put a crack and dance a tune underneath it. Failing Cork says, controversially, I think Nicole Kidman was born in Hawaii and is therefore American.
She is. But, you know, Australians will claim anyone who's successful. So she spent, she also...
No, the Irish will.
She also grew up, she spent a few years on, I think, Papua New Guinea, but she spent most of her grown-up years in Australia, and she considers herself Australian, except when she needs a work visa for America, and then she's an American.
Oh, yeah, good point. And, yeah, a few people pointed out she did that duet with... Robbie Williams as well. So.
Oh, she did too.
She did. Yeah. So
she's a great singer.
My girlfriend is really into wine, but I know absolutely nothing about it. I want to buy her a really nice wine as part of her Christmas present. Being honest, at least, part of my motivation is to show her that I spent a good bit on it, and I probably should make it actually taste good as well. Do any of your panel have any suggestions for something around the 100 euro mark? She likes red. That's the extent of my knowledge, says Brian. I suppose, first off, should he be buying her a bottle of wine?
Well, 100 euros is too much to spend on one bottle, in my view, you know? 100 euros is too much to spend on one bottle. Well, I mean, look, it'll be lovely, but, you know, once you get over 50, you're paying for scarcity. You know, you're not paying for quality necessarily. I mean, you are sometimes, but I think he needs to go to a really good wine shop and have the assistants talk him through, like a good old-fashioned independent off-license where the staff know their wines. And they
right.
can chat.
So how much should he be spending?
I think he could... Well, look, he can get a nice bottle of... I'm trying to think about at 100. What's about 100? See, Lynch Baj is 200 these days. That, you know, used to be 100.
What I'm thinking could he, like, spend 20 quid in a good bottle of wine and buy her an 80 quid pair of shoes?
I think, yeah, that might be a better idea. Well, I mean, look, he could get her something like, say, a Rioja Grand Reserva at sort of 35 to 40 euros. And then, then get something decent in like a popular discount store that we mentioned earlier.
Well, I mean, if Brian's girlfriend is listening,
he might meet a nice man in the queue.
He might, and that would ruin the relationship. So if Brian's girlfriend is listening, would you prefer Manolo's or a Lynch Baj? Text in and let us know. We have to take a break. Back in a couple of minutes.
Moncrieff on News Talk.
Malloy's, Dublin's oldest off-license, now delivering all your corporate gifts and wines nationwide. Shop in-store or online at malloys.ie. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
Looking to upgrade your van or pickup? The Ford Upgrade and Save promotion can help you do just that. Save up to €6,500 and future-proof your business. There's the eco-driven Ford Transit and Transit Custom, with mild hybrid and plug-in hybrid powertrains. And the 2020 International Pickup of the Year Ford Ranger. All tough, all reliable, all capable. All yours for less. Search Upgrade and Save or text Ford to 50015 and we'll arrange a call with your local Ford dealer. Texts cost a standard rate. Vehicles must be ordered by December 31st and registered by February 28th. Terms and conditions apply. See Ford.ie for full details.
This year, we've all missed out on special moments. So this Christmas, give the gift of memories with the iNewa Collection gift card. Perfect catch-ups over afternoon tea, treasured Sunday lunches, soothing spa days, or an overnight getaway at our 9 hotels across Ireland. From our 5-star Muckross Park Hotel to the Radisson Blue in Cork, Athlone, Limerick and Sligo. Plus, for every voucher over €100, we'll donate €5 to Down Syndrome Ireland on your behalf. Shop now at iNewa.ie. Merry Christmas from the iNewa Collection.
Once upon a time in Newcastle, County Dublin, somebody won a king's ransom of 29 million on EuroMillions. They probably bought a new castle, or two. The EuroMillions jackpot is a guaranteed 200 million euro. Play responsibly in-store, in-app or at lottery.ie. The National Lottery. It could be you.
This year, we're here to make your Christmas and fill your senses, not just your baskets. Go for all-out outfits, even if you're staying in. Give in to that first festive bite. Give back to those who matter and enjoy all the little things that make Christmas, Christmas. So shop smart, shop safe here at Dundrum Town Centre.
Hey there. Now you can't see me, that's radio for you, but I'm a cat. 9 lives and a whole lot of catitude. But getting to grips with health insurance, more slippery than Goldie over there in her fishbowl. Then I landed on HIA.ie. All the information you need to find the cover that works for you. Makes you feel like the cat's pyjamas. Not that I wear them. TMI?
Health insurance. Compare plans and prices at HIA.ie from the Health Insurance Authority.
At Kenwood, we have the range of mixers to suit every baking style. So whether you're an experienced chef or just starting out, you'll find your ideal kitchen companion online at powercity.ie.
Make this Christmas sparkle with Pandora's bracelet promotion. Still looking for the perfect gift or a festive treat for yourself? Spend €109 to receive your free silver bracelet. But hurry, this offer won't be around for long. Ends Thursday, 17th of December, while stocks last. Terms and exclusions apply.
100% new, still 100% Caddy. The fifth generation all-new Caddy Cargo is more innovative, dynamic and efficient than ever before. With €1,500 purchase contribution plus a Caddy Cargo service plan for €9.99. Contact your local Volkswagen commercial vehicles dealer or visit volkswagenvans.ie to reserve yours now. T's and C's apply.
It's almost 3 o'clock. Time to fill up at your local Texaco service station to give your car the quality fuel it deserves. Quality fuels, quality services, quality locations. Texaco, trusted in Ireland since 1924.
Across Ireland. Across Ireland. This is the IMRO Radio Awards National Station of the Year. This is News Talk.
It's 3 o'clock. Good afternoon. I'm Eamon Torsney. Two schools in Mayo and Laois have closed their doors until after Christmas. Claremorris Boys National School in County Mayo will not reopen until January 5th after 9 students tested positive for COVID-19. In a statement, the Board of Management says the decision is the right thing to do and is necessary at this stage. It made the decision despite Public Health saying there was insufficient evidence that the level of cross-infection between classes exist. Meanwhile, the Holy Family Senior School in Port Laois is also closed. It says the HSC has worked with the school, recognising the need to close on site from today, and education will continue online. The government insists no shortcuts are being taken in the rollout of a COVID-19 vaccine here. The Taoiseach has received the report of a high-level vaccine task force, and its recommendations will be considered by Cabinet on Tuesday. GPs, nurses and pharmacists will have a role, and there will be a communications campaign to encourage uptake. Government official Elizabeth Canavan says no corners are being cut in making a jab available.
Government will only permit the rollout of a vaccine if it meets the required standards of safety and effectiveness.
The Taoiseach has said the prevailing mood in Brussels is there will not be a Brexit trade deal. Speaking after attending the European Council summit, Micheál Martin said all politicians need to reflect on the consequences of that. EU and UK negotiators will make a call on Sunday as to whether there's any point in continuing the negotiations. Taoiseach Micheál Martin accepts the view now is there's likely to be no deal.
That's the prevailing mood right now, but that said, similar comments were made over a year ago in respect of the withdrawal treaty and the protocol.
And racism in schools can be curbed by a more inclusive history curriculum, according to equality activists. Youth Against Racism and Equality is holding a demonstration outside of Leinster House this afternoon, calling for the history of black, migrant and traveller people to be included in Irish education. Co-director of Pavey Point, Martin Collins, says his son was the victim of racial abuse in secondary school.
On at least 3 or 4 occasions leading up to sitting for his leaving. So as you can imagine, that had a huge impact on his mental health well-being.
That's it for now. More at 4.
OTB Sports on News Talk.
Sponsored by Betway. Bet the responsible way. 18+. Dunluey.net.
Good afternoon, I'm Richie McCormack. Ulster are the first province into Heineken Champions Cup action. Dan McFarlane's side welcomed last season's semi-finalists to lose to Kingspan Stadium tonight with kickoff at 8 p.m. While Connacht have been deprived of 4 players for Sunday's trip to Racing, one member of the senior squad has tested positive for COVID-19, with 3 others deemed close contacts. Alisson is set to return in goal for Liverpool for Sunday's Premier League trip to Fulham. Well, there's one game in the Premier League tonight with Leeds playing host to West Ham from 8 p.m. And Graham McDowell's withdrawn from golf's DP World Tour Championship. He shot a second round 76 to reach halfway in 5 over par. The lead in Dubai is held by Patrick Reed on 10 under. For these stories and more, search OTB Sports in your app store.
Introducing the all-new, all-electric Mazda MX-30. A compact SUV with enough energy for busy days. It has an incredibly comfortable interior that's made of calm and designed using sustainable materials. The lightweight body and impressively balanced handling means it's an electrified drive while being kinder to our planet. To experience the new Mazda MX-30, visit Mazda.ie.
News Talk Weather.
Thanks to the AA, you can find our best discounts on car insurance online. Go to the AA.ie.
A band of prolonged showers will move eastwards across the country during the afternoon and evening. Highest temperatures 7 to 10 degrees. And now you're up to date on News Talk.
Movies and Booze on Moncrief.
Brought to you by Lidl's award-winning wine range. Lidl, more for you. Enjoy alcohol sensibly. Visit drinkaware.ie.
Once I courted a pretty fair maid, and she was handsome, tall and young. Until at length I did discover that she had a false and a flattering tongue. If I had have loved her, foolish would I be, but love will never, never conquer me. Oh no, nor anyone will me control or keep me from my flowing bowl. When I am single, single I am free, love will never, never conquer me. Someday I'll get some riches, and I might have to take a wife. But we would fight for the old riches, and she would lead a terrible life. But boys know this never could be, for love will never, never conquer me. Oh, no, nor anyone will me control or keep me from my flowing bowl. When I am single, single I am free, love will never, never conquer me. I'll take a notion, and I might cross the ocean wave to where I could die without emotion. And these last words put above my grave: here lies a youth who never was tied to any old nag or scolding bride. For now, and I am single, single I am free, and love will never, never conquer me. Oh no, nor anyone will me control or keep me from my flowing bowl. When I am single, single I am free, and love never, never conquer me.
53106 is our text number. That will cost you 30 cents, or you can follow us on Facebook or Twitter. You are listening, and some of you indeed are watching the Moncrieff Christmas special with thanks to our friends at Lidl. That was our second song there from the Mary Wallopers, Love Will Conquer Me, and they'll be taking part in an event obviously, it's a streamed event at the Grand Social this weekend, the 12th and 13th of December. It starts at 11, finishes at 5, and it's called a Merchy Christmas. We can buy, obviously, merchandise to try and help, because obviously it's been a very, very tough year for musical artists to try to give them something of an income. Our panel are still with us. And actually, before we talk again to our panel, we do have some feedback from our remote tasters. As to what they thought of the wine. We have Ali, Liz and Maria.
I think the Chenin Blanc is completely delicious. It's a little bit spicy at just at the end of the taste. I think it's really refreshing and I love it.
I have to say, I'm not normally a white wine drinker, but that's quite nice. That might be on the Christmas list.
Definitely will be putting this on my Christmas list. Delicious.
Okay, there you go. That's all very positive. Somebody wants to know, Gene, what do you make of all the celebrity wines this year? Kylie Minogue and Cameron Diaz both released one recently. I'm not a big fan of Graham Norton, so I don't have much hope for Cameron or Kylie.
Well, actually, the Graham Norton wine is made by a New Zealand company called In Vivo. And in fact, I think they're very, very good.
And it's doing gangbusters.
It's absolutely selling like you wouldn't believe. And he's just literally released a Prosecco Rosé. And Rosé Prosecco is the brand new thing. The Italians just gave the law that they could make it as of the beginning of November. So that's something to watch out for this Christmas and in the future. But in terms of the celebrity wines, like, I mean, Cameron Diaz wine, they don't actually make it. They just put their name behind it. And the reason they're doing it is they're not making films. They're not out on the sort of the red carpet anymore. So how do you keep yourself visible? Well, you tie in with some wine company and you say, this is my wine. And it gives you enormous publicity and it makes you a few bob. So it's win-win all around. And in general, all the wines are pretty good quality because the people behind them are good quality winemakers. And they don't want these wines to be awful. And, you know, they're not going to make something that's dire because it's going to reflect on them. And if they've got a big Hollywood name making some, or, you know, be it Hollywood or even just, you know, one of our local celebs, you know, from wherever, they want something that people will go back and buy because everybody wants to make money out of this at the end of the day. So they're not going to make something awful that nobody wants to drink. They're going to put their best grapes in it. They're going to get a good winemaker. You know, they're going to say, okay, so he's very good. Get him to, or her, to make this wine. And, you know, most of the wines that I've tasted are pretty good. What about you, Leslie? I think they're all pretty okay, yeah?
Yeah, the Cameron Diaz one now. What annoyed me about that was that she pretended it was clean.
Oh, this clean wine. That's just a marketing
and
rubbish.
She was claiming there was nothing added. And, oh, look, I mean, her wine is no more clean than anybody else's. It's perfectly fine. It was completely generic.
That was
it
marketing.
Was three times the price it should have been. That annoyed me.
Yeah.
I thought Kylie's were pretty good.
Yeah, actually, Kylie's,
I am a fan of Kylie's.
Lovely,
I admit
that.
But if you really want a celebrity wine, Sam Neill, who has his own vineyards down in New Zealand, oh, they're fab.
And I was down on Felton Road in 2016, and he has this amazing silver kind of, what would you call it? It's like a caravan. I don't know what you call them. But
well, streamliner.
Yeah, and that's on his property, and I saw it. Yeah, and he's
worth a follow on Twitter. He's so witty,
and his wines are amazing. Yeah. They really, really are. There are a few, and let's not forget Francis Ford Coppola, who really started the whole ball rolling in the 70s in California. Yeah, I mean, celebrity wines, they are generally pretty okay.
And God, that was an orgy of name dropping there, wasn't it?
I have to say, I think the Graham Norton range is really, really good.
Yeah, I agree.
You know?
Yeah.
Donegal resident Sarah Jessica Parker has some as well. Yeah.
That's right. She loves hers.
Yeah, they're okay.
Please ask the wise one to recommend a place that sells a wide range of Belgian beers. Sean in Wicklow wants to know.
Oh, well, there's a great range in most of the good independent off-licences. So if you're in Dublin, Martin's in Fairview, Redmond's in Ranelagh, the Kerry out in Turlestown does a great range. Down in Cork, Bradley's or Matson's would be superb for the range of Belgian beers. And then any of the online stores will have a good range as well, yeah.
Emer says, contemplating getting my brother and sister-in-law a home brew-making kit. Any recommendations? Would your recommendation be don't?
You can work on different levels. A homebrew making kit can be literally a few buckets and a gas burner. It can be at a very, very basic level. You can get pre-made kits where they'll have malt extract and small packets of malt. There's generally different levels of home brewing. So extract brewing is where you're starting out and they've made the process of the start of the brewing process a little bit easier for you by providing extract as opposed to putting you through the mash process, and then it goes on from there. There is a system which is about $200-$300, I think, that is started up by two ex-Microsoft guys that is available in the US. I don't think available here. And it's kind of like an espresso machine for home brewing. I haven't had any experience of it, but they sell kits, and the kits then are supposedly branded beers. So you'll see something like Sierra Nevada or something like that as a kit, and that you think. Now, the reality is you are very unlikely to exactly match a Sierra Nevada Torpedo IPA with a kit like that, but it would head in a similar direction.
Going back to the prom, The Guardian has slammed Corden's performance in The Prom for being so over the top, camp and miscast. Like how Murphy could give him the job and direct him to give such a portrayal of a gay man. Bottom line of The Guardian columnist, straights shouldn't play gay characters, and he called it gay face.
The Guardian is UK based, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, it's an international publication. But isn't there a point, though? It's like straight characters playing playing gay people.
But then you're saying that gay people can't play straight characters either. So I think it's one thing to say playing race. You know, we've had that whole Scarlett Johansson whitewashing scandal. I think a lot, it's acting. So you're playing different characters. That's like saying I can't play a teacher because I'm not a teacher.
Yeah.
Or is that making it too simplistic?
Well, I don't know. Being a teacher and being gay are probably two different things. You don't go to gay college. Your parents aren't saying, "I hope you're gay when you grow up." Yeah.
I know, but I think in this case, for me personally, I think the best person for the role, Ryan Murphy cast him. And he said
and
he was the
gay.
Best person for the role. And I just take that The Guardian one with a pinch of salt, because I also think that, you know, and it's not just the British people. We do it here. The Australians do it. When someone of your own succeeds, tall poppy syndrome also exists.
Okay, that might be a point to it. Now, one of the wine experts that we don't have with us today is Mick O'Connell, and that's because we really don't like him. But more truthfully, it's because Mick is otherwise engaged. Mick just opened his own wine shop. It's called Neighbourhood Wines on Leeson Street in Dublin, and we can talk to him now. Afternoon, Mick. Mick, good afternoon.
Hello.
And congratulations to you on what I imagine is a very risky venture, because nobody's buying drink at the moment.
Nobody's buying booze at all. I mean, stuck at home, sticking to non-alcoholic juices and the likes. Kombucha's made a big impact this year. No, it definitely feels opening a business in kind of COVID times a little bit like a link somewhere between insanity and genius, and I'm hoping it falls on the latter.
I'm sure it will. Is it a very tricky process going through all this to get to where you are now?
I guess it should be, but we've kind of, it's myself and my business partner, Shane, and the two of us are very, we just head down and keep going stuck in, and it's actually been, it's all come together relatively quick.
Okay.
We've been quite lucky.
I know this is probably the least important thing, but it's called Neighbourhood Wine. Do you have to put a lot of thought into what you're going to call it?
You do, yeah. We went through about 100 names. There was all sorts and sizes. We were thinking maybe stem, because you have stems in grapes, and then it also, you've stem on a wine glass and all that kind of stuff. But look, then you have stem cell research. It doesn't sound quite as sexy, you know. So you wouldn't want to get confused with what you're doing. You know?
Exactly. Yeah. That people might be going in for a DNA test rather than a bottle of Bordeaux. Yeah. And are your own wines in the shop?
Yeah. So it's bits and pieces that myself and Shane have imported through the years. I have a little bit of the wine that I make in Sardinia sat there on the barrel beside me. We've all sorts and sizes, but we also buy from other importers and a bit of everything. Myself and Shane have very similar tastes, love Beaujolais, love Burgundy. So we've a lot of that stuff. And then we've a lot of quirky wines from all around the world, but then loads of classics as well. So you've got all the kind of Bordeaux and all your Italian stuff as well.
And is it hard work, Mick, in the sense that you have customers coming in who want to pretend they know more than you do about the wine, and then you have to kind of, you know, defer to them a bit?
In fairness, most of them probably do know a little bit more about wine than I do. Now, look, you know, the big difference from what I was doing beforehand is when you're selling to trade, you're not actually selling to the end person who's drinking. And I think here in the shop, you're getting to understand people's tastes, and that's a challenge, because we kind of, us wine geeks, use kind of one set of descriptors and vocabulary, and normal people use a slightly different set of vocabulary. So it's trying to get to know what people like, and then trying to make sure that they go away with the best bottle of wine for the occasion.
And so far, have you been pretty busy?
It's been good. It's been really good. I mean, the first couple of weeks, we were definitely kind of more busy than we expected to be. The third week that we were open was the one where everything else was back open, restaurants, pubs, etc. So we had a little bit of a dip then, which I think is probably normal. And then this week has been busy again on the ramp up to Christmas. It's been great.
That's fantastic. Anyway, enough about you. There's a lovely Prosecco from Lidl you want to tell us about.
I have a fab one right here, and it's a Magnum.
That's an impressive bottle.
It's a Magnum is always good enough to share if you're by yourself, is the trick with a Magnum. But this is great value. The beauty of a wine like this, it's $19.99. I mean, in general, with our sparkling wine taxes here in Ireland are huge. So trying to get anything at all at $19.99, even in a bottle size, is tough going. But getting a Magnum is fantastic value entirely.
Can we have another look at that bottle there, Mick? Leave it in chat there so people can feast their eyes on it.
This is the Alini, and it's a spumante style, so it's a full sparkling wine. A lot of the Prosecco that we'd see on a day-to-day basis here in Ireland is Frizzante, and Frizzante is a kind of softer sparkle. The spumante is a full sparkle, which is more like champagne or cava in terms of what is there. So, look, you've got fruity kind of style here. It's pears, it's apples, but it's refreshing, and I think the trick always with Prosecco is the Prosecco is fun. It's a party wine. That is why it's done so well here. Champagne can be quite serious. And it can be one of those things where a glass can sometimes be enough. But with Prosecco, probably a Magnum isn't quite enough, I would say.
And it's a handy one if it's a big size family. That's your man.
Exactly. You probably need two of these. Yeah.
And what's the ABV on that?
This is 11%.
Right. So that won't, knock you over.
You can have it for breakfast.
Yeah.
It's perfect. It's perfect. Actually, this is a good Christmas morning drink. And look, I'd say Lidl are probably going to have to put a thing on it where you can only one per customer or something like that. Because this is brilliant value. People will be going mad for a wine like this.
Prosecco on your cornflakes on Christmas morning. You can't beat that.
Exactly.
I would have thought.
Make
the very best of luck with the wine shop, though. I don't think you'll need it. That's neighborhood wine there on Leeson Street. And make happy Christmas.
Happy Christmas. Thanks, folks.
Moncrieff on News Talk. Down to business.
This week on Down to Business, I cook some festive soup on Zoom with the No Salt Chef. We ponder the future of the modern city with Conor Skean. Plus, I hear the lessons learned in business from an Irish-American digital goddess.
Down to business.
Brought to you by Bank of Ireland.
With me, Bobby Kerr, this Saturday morning from 10.
On News Talk.
Selling your car? At Zoo Car, we buy any car, even if you don't buy ours. It's quick and hassle-free. Fill out your details online and receive a cash offer, valid for 5 days. Visit zoocar.ie today.
It's the Great Sofa Scrappage Scheme at Flanagan Cairns. Purchase a new sofa or chair and we'll give you up to €150 for your suite or up to €100 for your replaced sofa. We've discounted all top brands like Tetra, Italian Divani and more. You also get free delivery, free assembly and we'll take away your replaced sofa free. The Sofa Scrappage Scheme is now on at Flanagan Cairns. Thank you for supporting Irish makers, Irish family businesses and for shopping local. Flanagan Cairns, Southern Cross Bray, exit 7 off the N11. Flanagan Cairns, furniture for life.
Head to Lidl to stock up on incredible deals for Christmas. With Cadbury, Maltesers and Galaxy selection boxes, now 3 for €9. Our delicious deluxe crisp selection starts at just €1.65. And there's 24 packs of Guinness and Carlsberg cans, 2 for €33. Lidl, more for everyone this Christmas. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
Thousands of Irish companies have transformed how they provide goods and services due to COVID-19 and are now open for business over the phone or online. You can support them by looking for local businesses and by using collection or home delivery services where available. By shopping locally and safely, you'll support local jobs and communities. Find out more by searching #lookforlocal. Brought to you by your local enterprise office and supported by Enterprise Ireland and the local authorities. An initiative of the Government of Ireland.
In Ireland, we're fighting COVID-19 with masks and distance. But in war-torn South Sudan and Syria, masks won't prevent hunger. Starvation is threatening vulnerable people every day. But an urgent gift to goal will help us save lives. It's a big ask, but it will make a very big difference.
You can donate at goal.ie. That's goal.ie. This Christmas, please remember Goal. Because there's no mask for hunger.
Try the latest vacuum cleaner technology from Bosch. The Power Protect system gives long-lasting cleaning performance, even as the bag fills up. Now with a full 90-day money-back guarantee. For more information, go online to powercity.ie.
Whether it's your home, wardrobe or health insurance, switching things up can make a big difference. Satisfy your switch. Switch your family to Laya Healthcare and unlock a world of benefits. Everyone gets the great cover you'd expect. And best of all, when you pay for one child, the rest of your kids go free. And you get unlimited access to GP video consultations and the prescription service. So you can keep your family well. Laya Healthcare. Looking after you always. Insurance provided by Ellipse Insurance Limited, trading as Laya Healthcare. Laya Healthcare Limited, trading as Laya Healthcare and Laya Life, is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland. Unlimited benefits are available until the end of 2021. Fair usage applies. Free kids offer available on applicable schemes.
If you want a better tomorrow, start heading for it today. Lower your emissions and pay less tax than diesel with Toyota's incredible range of self-charging hybrid electric cars. There's contributions of up to €3,000. And now, with a 2% VAT reduction, there's never been a better time to join the thousands of drivers who've made Ireland's best-selling car, a Toyota hybrid. Contact your dealer or explore the range at toyota.ie and start your electric journey today. Toyota. Built for a better world. Terms and conditions apply.
Let your Christmas story begin in a place not far away, where every Sunday Santa Claus will read magical tales for all the family to enjoy, where all your favourite stores and all your Christmas shopping await, and where you and your little ones can video chat with Santa Claus himself from the comfort of your own home. Let your Christmas story begin at liffeyvalley.ie.
Malloy's, Dublin's oldest off-license, now delivering all your corporate gifts and wines nationwide. Shop in-store or online at malloys.ie. Enjoy alcohol responsibly.
Movies and Booze on Moncrieff.
Brought to you by Lidl's award-winning wine range. Lidl, more for you.
Enjoy alcohol sensibly. Visit drinkaware.ie.
Your walls seem so high, they never fail to terrify. Built on fear and shame, your well misplaced words, they clip the wings of many birds. But my sky, you won't take. I'm crystal clear. I'm busting out of here, busting out of here. And I face my fears. Now I'm busting out of here, I'm busting out of here. I raise my ears, so I'm busting out of here today. Yes, we must be strong. It's hard to shake off Babylon. Chains are weak when strength runs away. It returns another day. Yeah. Then you're tough as teak. Crystal clear, I'm busting out of here, busting out of here. And I raise my ears, so I'm busting out of here, I'm busting out of here. I'm sick of fear. And so I'm busting out of here. I'm busting out of here. I prize my years. And so I'm busting out of here today. A shadow box today to keep the past at bay. But forgiveness is the key. If I hold too tight, I'm gonna block the light, and the sunrise I won't see. Yeah, shadow box today to keep the past at bay. But forgiveness is the key. If I hold too tight, I'm going to block the light. I want to feel the lovely warm sunrise in me.
Damien Dempsey there with Bustin' Outta Here. Now, another thing that Damien's involved in is the Sing All Your Cares Away. It's a schools competition and it's open to pupils of all ages. You can find out more about it at inspiringyou.ie for all the information. The deadline for entries to that is January the 15th, but you can find out all the details there. Our panel are still with us, but there is one interesting question for our two wine people. Lisa wants to know, what wine are your gurus putting aside for Christmas Day? If it's good enough for them, it's good enough for me, she says.
Okay, well, it's champagne for a start. You have to have champagne to start with. And I haven't actually decided. There's about, I kind of have a bunch of them in the house. I know Jean's a Bollinger fan.
Yeah, our family, our house great. Champagne in the Swollen family is Bollinger. So we'll start with Bollinger, definitely.
We usually have an Irish breakfast, you see. And so you can, I don't usually open the really good stuff first thing because you're going to mix it with a bit of orange juice maybe to cut through the fat and the sausages. Sausages and champagne are actually a really good combination, by the way.
Yeah. Marmalade as well.
Yeah, yeah, it's true. And for the red one, I literally haven't decided. I mean, but there's a lot of wine in my house, so it'll probably be Burgundy. But I may go with Southern Rhone, I quite like Chateauneuf de Pape and Gigondas and things like that.
Well, there's an Albert Bichot that I got when I visited Burgundy, gosh, nearly a decade ago. So that definitely has its name on this Christmas. Yeah, I love good Burgundy at Christmas. And unfortunately, I can't always afford it and I don't always have it. But, you know, if I can, I drink good Burgundy. I love it.
Okay, well, we'll move on to our first red wine of the day. It's a Chianti from our friends in Lidl. So tell us about it, Leslie.
Yeah, so this is interesting. This is a 2015, so the 5 years of age in this, Reserva Chianti, $8.99. The producer's Corte Alamura, which I confess I haven't come across before. Little are great at sort of finding these producers who kind of are clearing lines and so on, and they'll just take the whole lot and so on. And I think that they've done okay with this. Chianti is Tuscany, and Tuscany, we can't travel to Italy anymore. You would usually have been in Italy once or twice a year. And Tuscany was one of those great places. Florence, Siena, you know, even the names of them, Pisa, you know. And there's little hill towns, wine towns like Montalcino, where Brunello di Montalcino comes from. And what's the other one?
Now you're like me trying San to remember Gimignano, the name
San Gimignano. San Gimignano. Yeah. Anyway, Vernaccia di San Gimignano. So I just love Tuscany and the rolling hills and so on. There really is these lovely green rolling hills with wild boars coming out to eat the vines and so on. If you visit the vineyards there, they've always got nets up to stop the boars eating the grapes, and then hopefully they catch some and you have that with your dinner later on and so on. And it's Chianti went through a terrible time. I mean, it was, you know, post-war, Chianti became massively famous. Everyone drinking it in the flask, straw-bottomed bottles. And it was usually rot gut, usually awful stuff. They were really, really badly off after the war. They would just throw in white grapes. And hilariously, the Italian authorities decided to copy the French and look at how the French appellation system works. And they decided, right, well, what do the French do? Okay, well, in France, they look at the very best producers and they copy exactly what those guys do. So what are our producers doing? Well, they're all throwing loads of crappy white grapes in. Okay, by law, you must throw crappy white grapes in your Chianti. And so Chianti was terrible for years. Thankfully, anyway, in the 90s, they changed this, and Chianti is now back on track. It's always lighter. It's always got that sort of red fruit, always a bit of decent acidity to it and freshness. Serve it a little cooler. Don't serve it, we say room temperature, but it's room temperature of a castle in the 19th century, sort of 16, 18 degrees.
Yeah, I can see that. Yeah,
it's not, you know, but I think this has got lovely red fruits and $8.99, you know,
and
it does taste like a reserva. It was a nice warm year, 2015 as well, so it has lasted quite well.
Okay, yeah, no, that is very nice. Somebody wants to know, given that we're talking about celebrity wines, Dean, are there celebrity beers?
There are. Iron Maiden has done a beer called Trooper, and then they've done a few different variations on it. There's been a few other ones. There was a cider done by another heavy metal band. Then Neil Morrissey set up a brewery a number of years ago. Not too sure if it's still going, but he had a brewery going for at least 4 or 5 years. He was involved. It seems that there's on the beer side of things, it seems to be kind of proper beer geeks that are getting involved. You know, so the guy in Iron Maiden was very much into his beer.
Ma wants to know, my son is coming back from Tuscany for Christmas. Can your wine crew recommend a couple of nice Montepulciano's that I can get him to mule back for us for Christmas?
So Montepulciano d'Abruzzo is from Abruzzo, which is in the south, which is further south, okay? But there's a town con Montepulciano in Tuscany. So what she wants him to get is Vino Nobile di Montepulciano,
or
Brunello di Montalcino, which is nearby. So Brunello di Montalcino. Brunello di Montalcino. Sorry, I'm just trying to put my...
You're really like doing that accent, aren't you?
Or Vino Nobile, or Rosso di Montalcino, which is down the hill a little bit.
And they're clones of the Sangiovese grape. So, they're superior clones.
They're richer.
Really super. Mm.
And I once let people do this to you when you supposedly have knowledge. They hand you glass and say, so go on, what's this? So I was in Tuscany, and another wine writer handed me this glass. And I thought, oh, God... But here's the thing, I knew it wasn't Chianti because it was richer than Chianti. Brunello di Montalcino was always richer than Chianti, and I knew he wouldn't have been mean enough to give me something from Australia when we were in Tuscany. So sure enough, it was Brunello di Montalcino, because you can tell they're richer, they're fuller. Chianti's always that little bit more red fruit, this is a bit more plum. But they're lovely, aren't you? What do you think, Jean?
Pricey though, they are. Yes. They are expensive, so be careful.
Yeah.
And always remember, if you're coming home and you're putting it in a suitcase, just be careful.
Yeah, indeed. Of course, he'll have to self-isolate for 14 days. But the wine won't. somebody texted in to say, so with all the drinks you've had, can you even remember your first one? I can. I had a cup of tea when I came in. So there you go. Right, we do have to take a break. One more film to talk about after this.
Moncrieff on News Talk.
This year, we're here to make your Christmas and fill your senses, not just your baskets. Go for all-out outfits, even if you're staying in. Give in to that first festive bite. Give back to those who matter and enjoy all the little things that make Christmas, Christmas. So shop smart, shop safe here at Dundrum Town Centre.
QuoteDevil.ie can save you money on your car insurance, van insurance or home insurance. Quote Devil home insurance is so easy. Get a quote in just 60 seconds and purchase cover in 3 minutes.
The Quote Devil's always got one hell of a quote.
Quote Devil Limited is regulated by the Central Bank of Ireland.
Get Christmas wrapped up with Harvey Norman with gifts they'll really love, like the TCL 55-inch QLED TV. Watch all your favourite Christmas movies with apps like Netflix and Disney Plus, just $649. Or get the gift edition Dyson Corral with free Dyson brush and comb, just $499. And we won't be beaten on price with our best price guarantee. For more, see harveynorman.ie or shop safely in our spacious stores. Christmas wrapped up with Harvey Norman.
This isn't us.
Message is clear. This is
staying away from everyone.
Play their part.
Keeping our distance as we walk by.
Saying yes to rules and following them.
Impacting communities around our.
This isn't us. Except this is us.
Because we are doing this for us, for everyone.
This is us. Us at our best. Our most decent.
Knowing what we have to do and doing it.
Knowing that we're not there yet, but that we will get through.
Because, well, this is us.
Hold firm.
A message from the HSE and the Government of Ireland.
Certainty. With Volkswagen commercial vehicles, it's included as standard. Quality, performance, reliability. And now with purchase contributions of up to €3,500 and service plans from €9.99. For vans and offers you can rely on, always. Contact your local Volkswagen commercial vehicles dealer or visit volkswagenvans.ie. T's and C's apply.
Make Christmas magical with the perfect turkey from Dunn Stores. Available fresh in store every day from December 19th. Planning your Christmas dinner? We have something for everyone. Choose from whole turkeys, crowns, or turkey joints, or one already prepared with butter and herb stuffing. 100% Irish and Bord Bia approved, with that succulent texture and rich depth of flavour. Delivered fresh in store every day from December 19th. Dunn Stores. Make Christmas for everyone.
Body pain can affect your whole day. But Nurofen Endurance medicated plasters provide up to 24-hour effective pain relief to help you keep doing this, this, or even this. Nurofen Endurance 200mg medicated plasters contain ibuprofen for the short-term symptomatic treatment of local pain in acute muscular strains or sprains. Always read the label. Available in packs of 2 or 4 plasters. Please talk to a healthcare professional before returning to physical activity.
The Private Security Authority is the government body responsible for regulating the private security industry. Every day, licensed security services protect billions of euros worth of goods and ensure the safety and security of thousands of people and businesses. When choosing a security service for your home or business, choose one licensed by the Private Security Authority. If you choose an unlicensed security provider, you could face prosecution. Visit psa.gov.ie for more information and a list of licensed security services.
With incredible advances in neonatal care, more premature infants are surviving. However, babies born earlier are still at risk of developing blindness. The Rotunda Foundation is fundraising for a brand new digital retinal camera, which allows medical staff to detect and treat this condition. Please donate what you can at idonate.ie/rotundachristmas. Thank you.
Movies and Booze on Moncrief.
Brought to you by Lidl's award-winning wine range. Lidl, more for you.
Enjoy alcohol sensibly. Visit drinkaware.ie.
53106 is our text number. That will cost you 30 cents. You are listening to the Moncrief Show on News Talk, or indeed watching us online. This is our Christmas special, Movies and Booze, with thanks to our friends in Lidl. Jean and Dean and Serena and Leslie are still with us. Can you ask Dean if Saison is a good beer style to accompany Christmas dinner? And are there any good Irish examples you can suggest?
There are in Irish terms, the ones that really kind of pioneered the idea of doing an Irish saison were Black Donkey. And they've done a really good job, and they've done a range of them. There's also a brewery in the centre of the country that's doing some wild styles as well. Lidl have a saison in their range, and I take my hat off to them, because a lot of the time, as I mentioned earlier on, with own label ranges, they can stay away from the more eclectic, the more unusual styles. And with Saison, what you've got is you've got a lot of flavours that, when you name the flavours, they're unusual. So goaty, leathery, funky wet straw. You know, they're quite unusual flavors. What it is you've got a farmhouse ale yeast, which is a multi-strain yeast that's very natural and develops a lot of flavors. But you can get incredible fruity flavors and just amazing flavors. Very, very diverse style. It can go from pale through to dark, low strength through to high strength, and quite different in terms of the balance of flavors. But there's some great ones out there.
Okay. Probably a stupid question, but what's the difference between Shiraz and Merlot? I can't distinguish them. Is that only me? Jean, is that a stupid question?
No, it's not. They're two different grape varieties. Merlot is a French grape variety. It's native to Bordeaux. Shiraz is a French grape variety that's native to the Northern Rhone, particularly where it's called Syrah. But the Australians like to call it Shiraz. They're very different in style. Merlot is an early ripening grape, so it tends to have very little tannin. Shiraz is a much more kind of heavyweight, has more tannin, spice, bell pepper, you know, blackcurrant. They're two totally different grape varieties from different parts of France, now planted all over the world with very different flavor characteristics. The thing is, if they taste all the same to you, just keep drinking whatever you want.
Yeah, as long as you're happy. I got a bottle of 3CRU 2014 from my 50th in March 2020. A lot of 50-year-olds texting in today. Is it worth opening or holding on to?
That's an Amarone, I think.
And it's Rizzardi, yeah.
Yeah, from the Veneto. They're lovely wines, big, rich wines. They will keep, but I don't think they keep as long as some people think they keep. I drink it in the next 5 years. But it's good.
And actually, Lidl actually have a lot of Italians on their
shelves.
Loads
of Italians at the moment.
Yeah, they're really going.
Southern Italy, Primitivos and Nero d'Avilas and Barbera d'Alba.
Yeah.
Oh, I love a Primitivo. Peter in Ballantyre says he's a 2010 bottle of Lanson Champagne Black Label Brut. Would that be still good enough to drink?
You see, Gene might disagree on this. I like champagne with a bit of age in it. It gets all biscuity and like kind of Marietta biscuits and croissants and things like that. And it loses some of its fizz. But I know you like it a bit fresher, Jean.
Yeah, and the thing is, though, if it's not a vintage champagne after 10 years, they do go off and you can open them and they can be oxidized, right?
But he says it's 2010.
So 10 years, so it'll probably be a fine.
Keep it too much long.
No, I'd drink it this Christmas, yeah.
Okay, but it won't kill him.
No.
But it won't go, oh my God, that's amazing.
And it makes really good sauce for fish and stuff if you need to.
That's probably wiser. Now, you did make that tip about the woman, her son coming back from Italy and, you know, be careful with the bottles. This texture says, I made the mistake of thinking once you wrap wine bottles in clothes, it will be fine. I remember opening the case to pools of wine everywhere and loads of broken glass. A nightmare. How should you travel home with wine if you're flying?
So I have a yoke that it's effectively a plastic pillow bag that you blow up, and it's like an air cushion around it. And I always have two of those in my bag for when I have bottles. Bubble wrap. I would pack it into the upper part with the zip part of your suitcase. And I've actually never had a broken bottle.
Yeah, I normally take no more than two either. I'm not one or two is all you. But I wrap them in my clothes as well. And so far, touch wood, I've been lucky. I'm waiting for the day I open up and all the knickers are covered in rind. You know,
but you can get like we travel with. Sounds like we buy a lot, but we travel with a wine case holder, so you can fit two in there as well. And touch wood, so far we've never had any breakages.
Yeah. I did break a bottle of whiskey once, mind you. Thinking about it, yeah, that wasn't pleasant.
Right, I would have thought. The knickers covered in wine is the common experience. Anyway, we'll move on to our second movie of the day. It is Super Intelligence. Here's a clip.
We need to get you ready to meet George, and nothing on earth can stop us. Unfortunately, you still dress like a woman who works at a bird rescue.
Oh, my God, why would you do that?
Why? Because I can. Now do me a favor and do what Sergei says.
Who's Sergei?
I am Sergei.
There you go. That's Super Intelligence, as you saw there, Melissa McCarthy, the female James Corden. Right, so tell us.
So it's James Corden week here on Movies and Booze. If you're a fan of James Corden, you're going to be thrilled to hear that he plays the voice of the AI in this film. Basically...
Oh, no. Where
yes, he does. He does. So he's... His voice is in it the whole way through. You cannot get away from him. Basically, Melissa McCarthy plays a woman called Carol whose life has been taken over by this artificial intelligence who think the world has lost the plot. So if nothing changes in 3 days, he's going to press Control-Alt-Delete, literally, and just take over the world. So it's up to her to try and save the world, but she doesn't know that that's what she's doing. She's just trying to spend time with her loved ones and stuff. And I preface this with saying, because I think I may get a lot of backlash about this, because it was on Rotten Tomatoes, right? And the critics, usually when the critics give something a really bad score, I usually feel a bit better because the audience give it a really high score. They both gave, the critics gave it 23%, the audience gave it 28%. I would have given it about 60%. But
really?
But see, again, I don't think you should take a lot of my recommendations seriously lately, because
I'm a crap movie critic, says movie critic.
Because I really think that this year I'm really enjoying stuff that I would never have enjoyed before. Like
Serena.
Yes.
Are you pregnant?
This happened.
You've been around here a long time. This has happened before.
Do not wish this on me.
This was back in the kind of, I didn't really see it, but I had a nice nap in the cinema.
No. I just think I'm really emotional at the moment, right? Okay. So spending an hour and a half, I think Melissa McCarthy is the best friend we all want. The reason why this film works, again, if you're not a fan of Melissa McCarthy, stay clear of this film. But the reason why it works is, her comedic timing's amazing. She has such charm. It's about all those nice things that we want in the world, love, hope, kindness. It really touches on kindness a lot. And so I cried a lot. I think I'm getting out all these pent-up tears that I don't know exist. So I enjoyed it. I laughed. I saw people hugging. I saw people spending time together, and I really enjoyed it. Like I say this as well about Bill and Ted Face the Music. Remember when I watched that? I walked away going, did I really just cry in a Bill and Ted movie? So I don't know what is wrong with me this year. So I don't know, maybe with this one, know that I really enjoyed it. Is it going to be the most memorable film ever? No. Did I laugh? Did I cry? Did I have fun with Melissa McCarthy? Yes. So for me, it was just pure escapism for 2 hours. And I think sometimes that's what we need. But Rotten Tomatoes gave it 23% and 28%. So
right. Okay, when you say there's an AI wants to destroy the world, where does this AI live? In the clip we saw, it was in her car.
Well, see, this is the thing. So another thing that they're sort of touching on is how technology is all around us. And we're all told to be scared of technology, but technology can be a good thing as well. So it is everywhere. Everywhere that you can access technology. So he appears on CCTV, on our mobile phones, in computers, in dressing rooms, which is a bit scary. So he's appearing all over the place. And again, I actually liked James Corden as the AI in this.
So everywhere you went, James Corden could see you.
Yes, he could. And would I like that in real life? No.
That's a horror scenario, I would have thought.
But Bobby Cannavale is in this as well, and her husband Ben Falcone are in this. They look like they just had a lot of fun making this film. It translated onto the screen. It's a bit of a laugh, but take this review with a grain of salt. Vincent,
where could people avoid it? I'm afraid that rather than...
He's out at all cinemas now.
Oh, is it? So one of those? Yes.
This is in the cinemas.
Wow, so that's quaint. Yeah.
Yes, that's it.
Like, because I, when the local cinema opened up, I looked up and there was only like 3 movies playing and there was no movies for kids. And
so
limited offering.
Actually, for kids at the moment, there's 2x2 Overboard, which is a really cute Irish animation film, co-production. There's a few other, I think there's an English company and stuff involved as well, but that's actually really good for kids. There's also Cats and Dogs 3. I can't think of the subtitle because it's really bad, but my kids enjoyed watching that.
Yeah.
So there are a few things. There's Pixie, an Irish movie that's out at the moment in cinemas. So there are a few things out there in cinemas now.
Yeah.
If you just want to get out off your couch. And I have to say the cinemas are quite safe right now as well. Like they've taken every precaution.
But a lot of them, I don't even know how they afford to stay open given that they're only able to take at best 50% of the audience anyway.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's really tough for them. Maggie says, so I'm guessing this James Corden romp doesn't stick too faithfully to philosopher Nick Bostrom's seminal book of the same name.
God, no.
No, of course not. That's a book called Superintelligence, which they're being ironic, don't you know? Yes. My favourite wine is Passo Antico, an Italian red, but I know very little about it. Would they be able to share their thoughts and let me know a little bit about it, Jeff wants to know.
Okay, that's just the brand name. We need to know what region it's from, what
Well, region.
I don't know Paso Antica.
Yeah.
Is a 1979 Verve Clicquot still okay to drink?
Ooh, that's pushing it. You never know. Okay. Sure, open it and see. Could be fun. Yeah.
Jay says, does beer last as long as wine? And Jay volunteers that this may be the stupid question of the stupidest question of the day.
It's not at all, because with wine, the simple rule of thumb with wine is that white is a little bit, you need to drink it a little bit younger, and red will generally last a bit longer. For a beer, something similar, dark beers tend to last longer, strong beers tend to last longer. Sour beers, because there's so much going on in them anyway, they tend to develop over time. But if you're looking to vintage a beer, Imperial Russian Stout, Barley Wine, Flanders Red, Belgian Oudgoud's Lambic would work quite well. Oudgoud's
Lambic.
Oudgoud's Lambic. Yeah. Yeah. All of those will vintage very well. In terms of barley wine, English barley wine, which is quite hard to get, or old ale, will vintage a little bit better than American barley wine, because American barley wine tends to be focused around the hops, and anything with hop character will tend to lose its character sooner. In terms of the equivalent of a white wine in beer, if you've got an IPA, drink it as young as you possibly can, because you'll get the hop character out of it while it's young.
I looked up Paso Antico. It's a Sardinian appassimento made with dried grapes. It should be grand. Usually those styles are drinkable, pleasant, juicy.
Right. Okay. All right. That's our lot for today. I'm disappointed to say now, somebody did text in saying, why don't you do this every day? That's because our nerves couldn't stand it, doing a live stream like that. Thanks, of course, to Leslie and Serena and Dean and Jean. Always a pleasure to have them on there. Thanks also to our Zoom tasters. I think we can stick them up on the screen there. There they are there. Now, there is a delay, so they probably won't be able to say bye-bye to us. And thanks to the team who put this together. This was a lot of work. Thanks, of course, to Damien Dempsey and the Mary Wallopers for their performances. Thanks as well to Lidl for providing those lovely hampers to our Zoom tasters and to ourselves here. Also to our production team today, Johnny McCann, Paul Buckland, Byron Callahan, Stephen O'Donovan, Michael Quilligan, Aidan McKelvey, Aisling O'Reilly, Hughes at Home, and Claire Collins. That's our lot. Kieran's up next on News Talk. We'll talk to you on Monday at 2 o'clock. See you then.
The wren, the wren, the king of all birds, on Stephen's day was caught in the furs. Although he was little, his honour was great. Jump with me, boys, and give us a trail. I went down by Killinall, I met the wren upon the wall. Up to me, wattle, and knocked him down. I brought him into Carricktown. Drolling, drolling, where's your nest? It's in the tree that I love best. It's in the tree, the holly tree, where all the boys, they follow me. Up with the kettle and down with the pan. Give us a penny to bury the wren. Follow the wren 3 mile or more, 3 mile or more, 3 mile or more. We follow the wren 3 mile or more at 6 o'clock in the morning. I have a little box under my arm, under my arm, under my arm. I have a little box under my arm. If any of your tuppence will do me no harm. Up with the kettle and down with the pan. No, give us a penny to bury the pan. The wren, the wren, the king of all birds, and Stephen's day was caught in the furs. Although he was little, his honour was great. Oh, jump on me, lads, and give us a trade. Bottles of whiskey and bottles of beer. Oh, jump on me, boys, and give us a cheer. Oh, bottles of whiskey and bottles of beer. I'm wishing you all a happy new year.
Charge up for family adventures with the Land Rover range of plug-in hybrid electric vehicles. With pioneering hybrid technology, the Land Rover range offers the perfect balance of efficiency, power and performance, both on-road and off, making every journey effortlessly refined. Enjoy the road less traveled with ease. Explore the 2021 Land Rover range of plug-in hybrids at landrover.ie. Land Rover. Above.